Sawete, discipuli, discipulae, quae. One thing we learn when we start a new language is that different languages just don't have different words for everything. Each language has a different way of combining those words in a way to make meaningful statements. Let's look at an example.
Here's an English sentence. The daughter loves the sailor. The action in the sentence is loves. We call that word the verb. We call whoever is doing the action the subject of the verb. And in this sentence, the subject is the daughter. How do we know? Because daughter is in front of the verb. The order of the words in an English sentence shows us who's performing the verb. Whoever or whatever receives the action, called the direct object, follows the verb in an English sentence. Here the sailor is the direct object. He receives the love. Now look at what happens when we change the word order. The sailor loves the daughter. Now the sailor is the subject and the daughter is the direct object. The sailor is doing the action, the daughter receives it. The words are all the same, but if we change the order, the meaning of the sentence is completely different. Now, let's look at the same sentence in Latin. Filia nautam amat. Filia is daughter, nautam sailor, and amat is the verb, love. Notice that unlike the English, Latin likes to put the verb at the end of the sentence. Suppose we want to reverse the meaning of the sentence so that the sailor loves the daughter. We could write it like this, filiam nauta amat. So here we have the sailor loves the daughter. Now what did we do in our English sentence to change the meaning that we didn't do here? What did we change in the Latin sentence to show that the sailor is now the subject and the daughter is now the direct object? So we can see in a Latin sentence, the word order does not tell us who is doing what to whom, as it does in English. The endings on the nouns do, the forms do. Let's go back to our original sentence. Filia nautam amat. The daughter loves the sailor. We can put these words in these forms in any order we want, and the daughter will still be the subject, and the sailor will still be the direct object, whatever order the words come in. The sentence tells us that the daughter is performing the action and the sailor is receiving it because of the endings on the nouns.
What that means for your study of Latin is this. You'll not just be learning new words. You'll be learning different endings. And along with those endings, what each ending means for the use of those nouns in the sentence. We'll get into that in more detail in the next video.